And we back with another Great and Scared Reacts. I am one half of the Disrespective Collective, Craig Smith, a.k.a. Sensor Life, here with...
It's your boy, Quis, a.k.a. Dash. And today, we doing our boys, Pete and Bass, keys and bags. See the bar, though.
They should be right here somewhere, I think.
They are on... I know y'all was saying, y'all got to put them...
Y'all shouted out Harry Mack and seeing that. Also, shout out Tyler, too, for putting that together and making sure that it was good enough to make it and get us a new background. But we got Pete and Baz back here and Harry Mack over there somewhere.
Yeah. But today we got Keys and Bags featuring our boy PKJ. This was something that was in the... I actually saw this on the video a while ago. You know, we get to it. We gonna get to it.
Y'all
know
PKJ our boy with the bars? This little the UK character baby. And stuff with the mustache?
No, it's UK baby.
Okay, all right. UK baby. Okay.
PKJ. Yeah, it's UK baby. All right, let's go. Keys and Bags, Pete and Bass, PKJ, let's go. This seemed dark.
Find the lads in the club, no more, but still bust deals outside. Cut out white on the left, dishing out bags on the right. Dish, dash, dish, dash. I got the keys and bags. Dish, dash, dish, dash. I got the keys and find the lads in the club, no more, but still bust deals outside. Cut out white on the left.
Is it me? Hold on. Is it me or is the mix on this off?
It's a little off. The mix is a little, I'm not gonna say trash, but you could tell that this is
got the good engineer.
Because
I'm like, this is not a typical mix.
It's the rapper in me.
I'm like,
the sound on here is a little,
it's a little bad. It's a little issue.
It's a little bad.
Iffy. All right, let's go.
But I'm trying to listen.
I'm trying to get through that. I engineer a little bit too, so it's all messing.
We can throw a little volume on it or turn it up a little bit more from what it is already. If not, then we'll be good.
Find a lad in the club, no more, but still bust deals outside. Cut out white on the left, dishing out bags on the right.
This shit out bags to the right, okay.
I got the keys and bags, dish dash, dish dash. I got the keys and bags.
Find a lad in the club, no more, but still bust deals outside. Johnny went away for a long one. Now I'm smashing his wife.
Whoa.
Whoa. The disrespect. That's how you start off, Styles P. Oh. Disrespecting him right off top. He in jail and I'm fucking his wife. That's what I'm talking about.
Damn. Also, shout out. Y'all probably don't see it because the Great and Scale Reacts is up here, but also got to point out, we got Jada and Styles next to Pete and Bass over there, too. So that's another thing for y'all to look out for. But anyways, Styles Pete killing him. And that was a very grimy bar.
That was super grimy. But it's real life, though.
Come on, man. People done less. People done waited till their mans went to jail and done the same move.
Word.
No more, but still bust deals outside. Johnny went away for a long one. Now I'm smashing his wife. Fist fire at the front of the pub. When I pull out the stub, they run for their life. When I took it out, steal just once. And the stub knows gonna sneeze twice.
Six boys in the back of the truck. Emmys and Bings look down in the motor. Bags big with the windows up. I don't wanna get pulled over. Trust Big Neil on the wheel. And I trust Pat with their luggage. He laid down for a long one. And the young man never said nothing.
Bass in his back.
He went down for
Bass
a long
in his back.
And the young man never said nothing.
Man. You gotta have some real ones around, Bass.
I don't know why I love how tough these old men are.
Somehow they believable, though.
It's believable. I seen a dude. I was walking out of Woodman's, and it was a dude walking into Woodman's, the grocery store, and he looked like straight out of a Sopranos movie. He had the wife beater on, the gray, slick back hair or whatever, tattoos on him, the mustache and shit. I was like, this dude definitely did mafia time. Like, he's straight out of a mafia movie. And anything he would have told me then, I would have believed. This dude could have worked at Amazon or construction his whole life and had a nice Italian family. But if he would have stopped, if I would have interviewed him and he said, yeah, did this 20 years, blah, 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 knew John Gotti, I would have believed him just off of how he looked.
Hey, how you carry yourself, bro? It goes. It's like even when you in the hood, everybody in the hood ain't crazy. Everybody in the hood is like, bro. Most people in the hood is cool as hell. It ain't really no issues.
Yeah,
but the ones that's crazy, you know they kind of crazy, bro.
Like, hey, the ones that's crazy, us regular people from the hood, stay away from them too.
Yeah. Everybody get them their space. You know, go over there and do your thing, bro. Do y'all crazy shit over there.
I don't wanna get pulled over. Trust Big Neil on the wheel, and I trust Pat with their luggage. He laid down for a long one, and the young man never said nothing.
Buying the lads in the club no more, but still's that sign. Cutting out white on the left, dishing out bags on the right. Dish dash, dish dash. I got the keys and bags. Dish dash, dish dash. I got the keys and bags.
Alright, PKJ.
I smash your face in. Don't talk round here, you talk get left on pavement. Open the show for Octavian. That young man was amazing. Rise up to my mate Lodi. That's a young king in the making. I'm dripping up from Lodi. I took the pack, I sold it. Packed it, can and tune it. Light, I come alive at night. I got the guns and swords and telekins and C4s inside.
Alright.
Let me get PJ.
Go back to him. If this is definitely Colonel Sanders rapping. I know he's skinnier and he's smaller than him, but the look that he's giving, it's hard for me. This is crazy that this dude is rapping this way.
He came in so hard, though. Like, that shit was tough. How he just had him standing there. Like,
yeah, that's a wild picture.
And then it just got dark. He had the sound effect of the lower tone on there, too, with the... That's fire, bro. PKJ. I like PKJ, bro.
There's any captions for these videos, man, for real, because they would be unavailable, of course, right? Why wouldn't you? You know why they unavailable? Because even the captions sometimes don't understand what these. This is wild. I'm sorry,
that's
y'all.
The mix, bro.
That I'm sorry. My mix. Accent might, y'all might hear my accent and be like, that American accent is terrible. Oh, man, I can't understand what they're saying. And you're right. I'm not saying you're wrong. You're right. It's different to you. It's hard for me to listen and understand. And you know what's frustrating to me about it is that I really want to know. I really want to get the bars. I want to listen to what he's saying. But sometimes they rap so fast, and especially like you said with this mix,
I can't
really get or hear their vocals as clear. And I need to hear it that clear. That's the only frustrating thing I would say about not only this song in general, but specifically PKJ verse, because I really like PKJ.
Yeah, I think with it, sometimes it's hard for me. It's certain words I miss. That's why I actually ask the people, like, yo, what did he say there?
Yeah,
like,
yeah. And shout out to y'all for letting us know what stuff means.
And be respectful. Y'all just let us know. Y'all don't be on no BS. Like, y'all just let us know. Cause sometimes we don't know. But I think on this one, a lot of this is because some of Pete verse was hard for me to grasp. I think it's just the mix. The mix is definitely not as crispy as they stuff usually is.
Yeah, because we usually don't have this problem so much, except with the lingo. We might not know what a word means, but at least we can hear the word.
Yeah.
I feel like the mix on here is probably a little too bad.
It's older joints, too. So.
For us, I shouldn't even speak for you. For me specifically, to hear it as clear as I would want to hear it.
I heard PKJ. I like the PKJ first, but
I love the cadence and the flow.
Yeah, it still wasn't crispy.
I want to hear specifically every word.
I'm literally zoning. That's why I say play it back. I'm trying to zone in.
Yeah, I'm just being picky personally. I want to hear it clear and specific and understand it 100%.
The song fire. That's what's even more frustrating because the whole shit is, it's a vibe.
I'm just frustrated that I got to listen harder than I intend to, but it's not impossible to get.
I understand exactly what you're saying, bro.
That's a young king in the making. Light, I'm dripping up from Lodi. I took the pack, I sold it. Packed it, can and tune it. Light, I come alive at night. I got the guns and swords and telekins and C4s inside.
So basically,
they did something wild to his voice. They did some Kendrick Lamar type stuff to his voice too.
They gave him the chop and screw thing. So what he was trying to, like, if you listen to what he was saying, he was on something like he's possessed, like on some demon time. That's what he was talking about. Okay. But the mix is bad, so it kind of just make it sound like a bunch of noise. That's why I say I don't understand exactly what you're talking about, because I was trying to pinpoint exactly what he said in every little word. And I could only catch, like, it's still stuff I couldn't understand because it just, the mix is just
bad. For those of y'all, if it's the dude that be rocking and he be putting the whole verses in there, if you show up in the comments,
please put the whole verse in these comments,
I'll definitely re-listen to this and watch this video and read your verse
I can't remember my man's name. Rapping. He showed me doing that too, and appreciate you for doing that, bro.
But yeah, shout out to you for that, because this one is the one that that's good to have, and I'll go back and see what I got wrong. But this one I would definitely really specifically need it for, because it's just hard to understand it. I do like the beat. I like the flow. I like the cadence and the stuff.
They should read.
Pete and Bass. Pete and Bass, was pretty.
Bass, I could hear. I can hear Bass.
Pete and Bass
good.
Was fine. I'm kind of mad that I can't hear PKJ as clear as I want because I do like him and I want to hear his verses clear and I just really can't get his words specifically. But what he did with it and his flow and his cadence, like lies, lies, da da da. Like
PKJ lies. Like he's basically saying like you, like he was saying was dope. But it's like
I know it's rocking in on beat. I just want to know lyrically specifically what he was saying. Yeah. So before I like comment and really, you know, oh, this is a whack or not or whatever. But I can't say it's whack because I already like the cadence.
It's
I just really
the,
knew.
Definitely
I just really wish I knew lyrically exactly what he
definitely,
said.
Definitely
and
mix.
If it was clearer, I would know. But Pete and Baz, though, they definitely, I know, I heard their lyrics. I heard their words. It could be that I'm used to hearing them, too. That could be it.
I got the ones and stars and telekins and C4s inside. Buying the lads in the club, no more, but still, that sign. Cut out white on the left, dishing out bags on the right. Dish, dash, dish, dash. I got the keys and bags. Dish, dash, dish, dash. I got the keys and bags.
I got the keys and bags. Right. I got the keys and bags. Big stash, big stash. I got the keys and bags.
I wonder if dish dash is like I serve and then I'm out of there. Like I serve and then I'm gone.
I thought he was saying something
dish
different.
Dash.
He was saying dish dash.
I thought he was saying dish dash. Dish dash. I'll call the keys and bags.
You might. You probably more right than me, then.
Either that or a mishmash. Mishmash. I'll call it keys and bags. But I think it was dish dash.
I thought he said, I heard something completely different. Dude, y'all got to get the mix. Re-record this, bro. I thought it was lit, too. But still, it's like, you might be more right than me. The mix was definitely off, bro. I heard as soon as they started, I'm like, the mix off.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel like the song is dope. And I'm mad that the mix is off because I want to really, like, hear this how I typically hear Pete and Bash though. I'm gonna get this a I feel like it's bogus to like. I'm gonna get this an incomplete. I don't even want to judge this.
I'm gonna give it,
I feel like I would love this if this was mixed right.
I'm giving it a B because as a person who had terribly mixed music for a lot of his I'm talking about I got 7 projects done from when I started rap from Humble Beginning all the way to King Poetic 2. It's 7 projects, including those two. It's 5 projects in between those two. King, maybe the last 3.
I say a couple of them were smooth, though. A couple of them, the mix was
maybe the last 3 or 4. I'm going to say the last 3 to go with the lower number. Maybe the last 3 was done when I finally was like, let me stop recording this in my closet myself and go into a studio and let somebody do this. So those sound way better. The ones that's on Spotify, those sound way better. But the first ones, terrible quality. Terrible me doing it, figuring it out. Not even, no engineering school, no sound, nothing. Just being like, if the beat not louder than the vocals, I should be good. Like, so, as a person that had terrible quality like that, I'm going to still grade it and give it a B because I know, hey, sometimes it just be like that. And then nowadays, with everybody having home studios, quality of music has lowered
definitely
very much. You don't even an unmixed song could go number 1, so
it can be cracking before anybody ever master it or anything.
Exactly,
you know what I'm
exactly. So I'm a go ahead and still grade and go ahead and get them to be on that one because
that's fair, bro. I'm gonna still give like it an incomplete, but you're right. Everything you said was correct. I don't even want to judge it because I still like it. I still like it now, and it's like I know if this was like they typical quality like. Whoever mixing their stuff now, this would be just like that much better. So, yeah,
and I know it's terrible to say, but if this was any other rapper in America that had terrible quality like this, only because that's how we used to understand the language, we could figure it out or pick up on it.
Oh, yeah, if they was American, we would have been able to steal.
We might miss stuff from there, but unfortunately, yeah, the accent be heavy sometime. I'm only being real. The accent be heavy sometime, and especially with the rapping and shit, and I would want to hear clear.
Because I can pinpoint it out when it's like the way it's typically mixed. I gotta listen hard, but I can I actually like it. It's kind of a part of their like style to me. But this one was just hard because the mix was definitely.
And I'm talking about PKJ specifically because I heard Pete and Bass. I got that. But the extra thing they did, the auto-tune, whatever they did for PKJ, made it hard for me to understand him. And he was kind of one of the people, I'm a little bit more hurt because he was kind of one of the people I was looking forward to hearing on this. Because I do like
PKJ.
Him.
PKJ created.
So that's what kind of threw me off and made me feel like, oh, like let down a little bit about it. But I definitely still heard. I don't want to make it seem like that. I still got Pete Bass, though.
It's still fire. We're not
still fire.
It's definitely just.
I just wish they didn't.
The mix threw both of us off.
Mix PKJ like that, and I would have got his lyrics clearly like I wanted them. But I'm going to still get out of B, though. No doubt. I still rock with
it. They're going to remix it, and then we're going to do this again. Hit the like button. Put somebody on. Who'll put somebody on. It's me, your boy, some disrespect to Collective. I'm your boy, Queese, a.k.a. Dash, with my mans.
Craig Smith, a.k.a. Sincere Life.
And shout out to my boy, Tyler, behind the scenes for Radio 22, Everything 22. And we'll get at y'all next time. We out of here. Dizzle.